want to know how to do affiliate marketing on Facebook? Then this video is for you. Hello, I'm Sophie, Millionaire Mom, and welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to show you two ways in which you can do affiliate marketing using Facebook. It is completely possible. Many people do it very successfully. I'm going to share my screen, show you exactly how you can do it. Let's go. So here we are. We are on Facebook. Now, if you want to do affiliate marketing only using your Facebook profile, it is possible, right? It is possible. It is going to require quite a little bit of work, okay? So what you are going to need to do is first you're going to have to optimize your Facebook profile. I have videos that show you exactly how to do that. But you know, your Facebook profile is going to have to be very clear about, you know, what it is you do, how it is that you help people. And you're also going to have to post very regularly and consistently so that people basically, you know, so that you establish a presence on Facebook. Basically, that is the idea. In your post, you're not really going to promote actively your products, right? But you can definitely create some curiosity so that people will want to reach out to you. You can also really establish authority. So, you know, give tips and tricks, and that way people will, you know, gradually get to know you and get to view you as an authority, and then they will reach out to you. I will give you an example, for instance, of this. For instance, you know, the other day I posted a quick post with a tip. I generally post Thursday tips on my Facebook profile that are kind of relevant to my niche. And then here I put a little PS. This post is scheduled, yes, on my Facebook personal profile. Want to try it? Message me. And as a result, I had two people who messaged me, reached out to me and asked me, what is it that you're using to schedule your Facebook posts, right? And I sent them a link, and I haven't made a sale, but I might make a sale, you know, further down the line. So that's just a little example where I'm not actually actively pitching people. I'm not telling them this is a great thing, you have to, you know, you have to get it, click the link. But I'm creating a little bit of curiosity. And, you know, some people see my posts and some people think, oh, that could be useful, I'll reach out to her, right? You could do this in absolutely any niche, right? Let's just admit you are promoting dog training products. Let's just admit. So, you know, you could really regularly post on your Facebook profile, you know, about your adventures with your dog and how you use this product, or how you found this new technique and your dog did this or that, right? Or how you helped a client with this new technique and they got a good result. Whatever, you know, you can share funny anecdotes, put little pictures of dogs and stuff like that. And occasionally, you know, maybe every 3-4 posts, you put a little thing saying, do you want the same results? Reach out to me or comment below, right? You know, you can put, you know, let me know in the comments, hashtag dog training. And then after a while, people will reach out to you and want to find out more. I hope this makes sense. The whole idea, if you're using your personal profile, the first thing is to, you know, optimize your profile so that people know what you are about, and then post very regularly so that, again, people realize that you know what you're talking about and they know how to reach out to you if they want to have the same results. Okay, that's the first thing. Now, of course, that in itself is not enough. You're also going to have to interact. You know, you're going to have to go to your newsfeed and interact on other people's posts. Otherwise, if you're just posting and not doing anything else,
Facebook is just not going to show your post to many people, okay? So, you know, it's very important that you also spend quite a bit of time every day. You know, you don't have to spend hours, but, you know, spend 15, 20 minutes at least interacting with other people's posts, leaving comments, leaving reactions, and also, you know, reply to people's comments on your posts, obviously. Make sure you also add friends regularly, right? So maybe go in groups that are relevant to your niche. Again, let's take the dog training example. If you're in the dog training niche, go, you know, be in a few dog training communities, right? In there, make sure that you give value. Don't pitch, don't tell them, I have this great product that will help you. But just, you know, answer people's questions. Be helpful. Tell them about your experience. Turn up very, very regularly, right? Daily, if possible. Then, you know, if there's a few, you know, occasionally send a friend request to some people of the group. And also you will notice that if you turn up very regularly in a group, people will start reaching out to you. They will start sending you friend requests. You know, they'll go and check your profile. They'll send you friend requests. They will reach out to you and ask for your help, right? That's the way you would do it, only with your personal profile. Quick tip, by the way, make sure that you set your posts to public so that everybody can see them, right? This post was actually a mistake of mine, but anyway, for instance, here you can see here this is set to public, right? If you set it to I'll show you, if you set it to friends, it's only your friends, right? But if you set it to public, anybody can see it. So make sure that you set your posts to public, because again, when you're interacting in groups, people will probably go to your Facebook profile and check you out. If all your posts are private, then they won't be able to see what you're posting. So it's important to do that, okay? So that, in a nutshell, is how you would do it only using your Facebook profile. Right? Again, I have some tutorials in my Facebook tutorials playlist that teach you, you know, much more in depth exactly how to optimize your Facebook profile, how to add friends, you know, the tools that you can use can help you with this method. But this is just an overall view. This is how you would do it. Okay. Now, another way you could use Facebook for affiliate marketing, of course, is by creating a Facebook group. And in fact, I would encourage you to do that. I believe it's going to be easier if you have a group as well, okay? Because in a group, you know, it is a bit of work, obviously, if you create a group, because you're going to have to nurture, grow the group and nurture it, look after it a bit. But on the other hand, you know, when people join your group, then you actually have a community of people who are interested in what you do, right? So I'm going to show you again, you know, with my own group. Obviously, it's my me to show you how I do it in my own group, but this is just as a model to, you know, for how you could do it in your group. So, you know, the group doesn't have to be very big at all. But, you know, basically, you can create a group around what you are doing. So again, let's say you are, you know, let's say you're a fitness, you know, fitness trainer, right? So you would create a group which would be, you know, fitness for middle-aged women, right? Let's think, I'm thinking of myself, right? So, you know, make sure your Facebook group is a little bit specific. There are many Facebook groups out there, right? So, you know, for me, my special angle is for busy people, right? Because I'm very busy, and I thought that's kind of my special angle. So you know, once you've created your Facebook group, you then obviously start posting, you know, again regularly about the topics that people, the problems that people have, right? This is the thing. If you want to make money, you have to solve people's problems. So, you know, research what people's problems are, Right? Again, if you are in the let's take my fitness example, right? If you are, doing fitness for middle-aged women, you can go in other fitness groups and kind of see what are people struggling with, right? What are middle-aged women struggling with when it comes to fitness, right? Maybe they don't have much time because they have a family life. Maybe they just I don't know, whatever their problems are, right? And then you kind of post about these, right? About the problems that they have, offering them sort of, tips and tricks and regularly pointing them obviously towards products that are going to help them specifically. Hope this makes sense. The way you can do it, what you need to do as well, I think, at least in a Facebook group, is make the use of the guides, right? You can create guides. They used to be called units. but this really means that you can make, a real little database that's helpful to your audience. For instance, so I've created, affiliate marketing basics. I know that people, struggle to understand even what is affiliate marketing, how to get started, the tools they need. So I've kind of made little video presentations. For me, it's video presentations, but you don't have to make video presentations. You could just make, written posts or put little PDFs, whatever. Things that basically are going to be helpful to people, right? So, you can basically create some content, some helpful content that's going to help people in your niche. Then the thing you can do is I'll show you what I've done, for instance, in this video where I explain, what are the essential tools, right, that people need in affiliate marketing. I made a quick video, very, very simple video. I mean, honestly, you don't need to do anything really fancy, but there you go. In the comments, one of the things that you do need if you're doing affiliate marketing is an autoresponder, for instance. So I put a link to the autoresponder, and this is my affiliate link. So, when people go through this basic training, if they haven't got an autoresponder yet, they decide, yes, I'm going to go with this one. They click here, and if they then go to sign up, then I get a commission, right? You could do this with absolutely anything, right? Absolutely anything. So this is just an example. I'll show you as well what I've done in the, when people join my group, for instance. Bear with me a minute. There you go. So when people join my group, I have a pinned post here. You can very, very easily create a post that you pin. You click here, and you see I've put it as an announcement. There it says remove announcement. But if I initially you have to do it, mark it as an announcement. That way it's actually pinned at the top of the group when people join the group. And in here, as a welcome post, I tell them, watch the video. So I've got a little video. You don't have to do that. You don't have to. I love being on video, so I tend to make videos. But then, my next one is step two. It's a PDF. Now, this PDF is basically a little guide to have success with affiliate marketing. In the PDF, of course, it has affiliate links, right? I put a disclaimer. Obviously, I explain to people that it has affiliate links, but this is going to be helpful to people. It helps them get started. And also, if they click some links and sign up to things, I get a commission, okay? So, this is just to give you an idea of how you could do it. Obviously, creating a Facebook group is it does take some work, but then you have a community, and people, if you turn up very regularly, People then are going to trust you that you can help them with whatever they're struggling with. And that's, then they're way more likely to click your link and buy from you, right? So that's a powerful way that you can do affiliate marketing on Facebook.
So that was easy, wasn't it? I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel if you enjoy my content and want to see more of it. Now, if you have any questions, anything that was unclear about doing affiliate marketing on Facebook, then please post them in the comments below and I will get back to you as soon as possible. I will be making more videos about affiliate marketing on other social media platforms. So again, if you want to see them, make sure you subscribe to my channel. That's it from me. See you in the next video. Bye for now.